Today I'm house hunting in and around Mojacar on the beautiful Spanish Costa de Almería. I'm Jasmine Harmon, and for over 15 years I've been helping house hunters find their dream homes overseas. Today I'm going to be using all my skills to find the perfect family holiday home for Vicky and Marvin. The Spanish sun certainly fires their imaginations.
Compared to the solarium before, this just knocks it out of the water, doesn't
it? Exactly.
And they're definitely looking forward to the laid-back lifestyle.
You've got gardeners that will look after the garden. Does that appeal to you?
Definitely. Yeah. Yeah.
I get to visit a luxurious house with stunning glass walls.
They were trying to convince us to put glass windows through the toilet, but we didn't go down that route.
Oh, so you have got a door on the toilet,
at least. We have got a door on the toilet.
But at the end of the day, can I raise my game high enough and help my house hunters get themselves a perfect place in the sun?
Jasmine, you've given us a problem, but a nice problem.
Vicky and Marvin have always dreamt of owning a holiday home in Spain that they can escape to for long weekends and school holidays with their twins, Paige and Oliver, and their chihuahua, Daisy. And they've decided there's no time like the present to make that dream a reality. Vicky and her husband Marvin live in Addlestone in Surrey and tied the knot nearly 10 years ago.
We met at work, the usual story. How many years? 20, 25 years ago?
About 20 years ago.
20 years ago, okay.
It's not that long, it just feels like that, doesn't it?
As well as finding a house that their 12-year-old twins will fall in love with, keeping their chihuahua Daisy happy is also a big priority.
I can't believe that we're as besotted over this dog as what we are. But yeah, she is like our third baby. Obviously, we want to spend longer periods of time out in Spain. We'd want to bring her with us.
Vicky and Marvin love the Spanish coast, and even though they've never visited Mojacar, they have a hunch it will suit their family nicely. They're heading out with a budget of £250,000. The town lies on the Costa de Almería, which is around a three-hour flight from most parts of the UK. You can then drive to it from the airport in just under an hour. It's a place with a bit of a split personality. Mojacar Playa is the lively modern beach resort, while the separate historic hillside village of Mojacar Pueblo is set a mile or so back from the coast. The area hasn't been heavily developed and there are relatively few high-rise buildings to spoil the amazing sea views. This region is one of the driest places in Europe, and Brits escaping the weather back in Blighty now make up around a quarter of its residents. Mojacar is the most expensive area on the Costa de Almería, with prices for a modern four-bedroom villa with a pool starting at around £327,000. But further along the coast, similar properties can be up to 25% cheaper, which is great news for Vicky and Marvin. Before we get cracking, I'm meeting up with our house hunters on Mojacar Playa's largest beach to find out exactly what they're looking for. So how is it for you two, your first visit to Mojacar?
It's stunning, isn't it?
It's ticking every box.
Yeah.
So what made you settle on this area of Spain?
We just researched endlessly, looking for something a bit more authentic and not so built up.
So tell me about your family and how you're planning to use this property.
We've got 12-year-old twins, Oliver and Paige, so it will be used as a holiday home to start with.
And with, you know, friends and family coming over.
Yeah.
And then hopefully more of a retirement home as we get older.
Can you describe what it is you've got in your mind?
Minimum of three bedrooms, ideally four bedrooms. We'd like the kids to feel at home and have their own bedroom if possible, and then to have a guest bedroom ready and waiting. So with our children, I think, as long as it's got a pool.
That's it. That's their only criteria.
They'll be happy. Yeah.
In regards to the location, as long as it's quite close to the beach and some amenities around, that's what's important.
In four bedrooms, walking distance to the sea is quite tricky. The vast majority of properties close to the seafront are two-bedroom apartments, with a few three-bedroom properties thrown into the mix.
We do know there might be a compromise on that somewhere.
So let's talk about the budget, shall we? How much are you going to give me to spend?
Okay, so initially it's 250, and then with a wiggle room, up to 300.
So a maximum of 300?
Yeah, unless you find the absolute real deal, and then there's a little bit, just a little bit of wiggle room on that as well.
I mean, when you say a little bit more, what, 310, 320, what are you thinking?
Yeah, less than 320. Well, less, yeah,
right, 310. Okay. I'll definitely help you spend that money. You know, that's absolutely fine.
I think I've got a really good option for us to start with. So, how are you two feeling?
Excited.
Are you?
Let's get it on.
Let's go.
Oh, I can't believe you just said that.
I'm loving the enthusiasm. Vicky and Marvin have never visited this part of Spain, and before we look at our first property, I want to whisk them up into the historic whitewashed village so they can get the full lay of the land.
Look at the views from up here. They're stunning, aren't they?
Yeah, they're amazing.
This is better than what we expected. Yeah. No two ways about it.
We've come up to Mojacar Pueblo, which is the original village from which the whole resort of Mojacar has grown. It's got that lovely, authentic Spanish vibe to it. Little, tiny, winding streets, lots of lovely restaurants and art galleries here, lots of people making their own arts and crafts and selling them in their own little shops. Is this something that the kids would like?
Yeah, Paige would really love it. She'd be in all the little shops.
Absolutely.
I don't know about Oliver.
Yeah, Oliver would get quite bored after a while.
And ice cream.
Yeah, absolutely. The little cafes, the ice cream parlours, you know, he'd be all over that.
There's a bus that goes from here down to the beach every half an hour, costs about £1. Where we're going for our first property is actually back down towards the beach. We don't have to get the bus though, we'll go and hop back in the car.
All right,
yeah?
Of course then.
We're kicking off our house hunt right in the heart of the resort of Mojacar Playa. This area is packed with shopping centres, restaurants and bars, and is close to those enticing waves, so I'm hoping it'll appeal to the whole family. This is the most expensive area on the entire Costa de Almería, so it's good that if needs be, Vicky and Marvin's budget can stretch beyond their £250,000 starting point. Our first property is in a central residential area close to the town's main strip. It's on a site with around 80 separate properties, all of them 2 and 3 bedrooms. Apartments and mostly used by Spanish families as holiday homes. Dogs on leads are welcome in the communal areas, which should keep their chihuahua Daisy happy.
Now, look how close we are to the beach.
Wow. It's perfect.
Yeah, the location hits the nail on the head.
So we are looking at a property in this development just opposite.
It looks really nice and modern and clean.
Okay. It's this one just here, actually, with the pink flowers on the ground
floor.
It's a 3-bedroom apartment. It's all been recently renovated. How do you feel about the fact it's 3 bedrooms?
As long as there's space in the lounge for a sofa bed, then, you know, happy days. You know, we'll accept that compromise.
It's on the market for just under £284,500.
The proximity of the beach, there's going to be a premium for that.
About
you know,
that,
outside looks good, so let's have a look at inside and let's just see if that stacks up.
I hope it does. Shall we go and take a look and see if it impresses you?
Really? Yeah.
Our first property is shaping up nicely, and being so close to the beach is a major plus point. This apartment has a spacious terrace overlooking the communal pool and landscaped gardens. It also has its own entrance porch. This leads through to a super stylish modern kitchen, which opens onto the living and dining room with its access to the terrace. On the same floor, there's a main bedroom with an ensuite bathroom, 2 more good-sized bedrooms, and a shower room. Fingers crossed that Vicky and Marvin like the inside as much as the outside.
So, we come straight into the kitchen.
Wow.
Is this what you're expecting?
Not as good. It's lovely and modern and sleek, so pleasantly surprised, yeah.
Do you think you'll be spending much time in here?
Unless it's out of the freezer into the oven, that's my style of cooking. And you cook 2 things, don't you, from scratch?
Yeah.
So what are your signature dishes?
Spaghetti bolognese, as every man can, and chili con carne, which is just a spicy spaghetti bolognese.
With rice instead of pasta.
Absolutely.
So, out on the terrace.
It's beautiful, yeah, it's absolutely perfect. This is what we were wanting,
the
isn't
pool
it?
Pool size, sure. The grounds.
Yeah, it's so
terrace.
Pretty.
Yeah.
It's really well kept as well.
Would you two be perhaps sitting out here, the kids in the pool?
That's a good thing as well, because they could be in the pool and we could see them.
Yeah.
That's a perfect position, actually.
Why don't you two go and have a look at the rest on your own, and we'll see where to go from here.
Okay, perfect.
All right.
Thank you.
Enjoy. Well, it seems like we've started off with a bang. They love it.
It's bright, it's big.
Yeah.
Enough wardrobe space for you?
Yeah, 2 lots of wardrobes. You can't ask for more than that, can you?
Ken, another box ticked, isn't it?
Yeah.
Room is good, but the compromise on the four-bedroom to three-bedroom, I believe, would have a problem with this room.
Yeah, I thought it might be a little bit bigger, to be honest with you.
If it was just the four of us, it'd be perfect, but having visitors coming...
Oh, it's a shame.
But everything else is ticking the boxes.
Yeah, it's really nice.
I'm hoping this three-bedroom apartment near the beach on the market for just under £284,500 will suit Vicky and Marvin nicely. Could we have a contender on our hands already?
So, you've seen your first property in Spain?
I have, yeah.
How's it feeling?
A little bit more real now, isn't it?
Yeah, very
Yeah, we've been so. Pleasantly surprised with this one.
So what did you like about this place?
Bedroom's all the right size, you know, kitchen's fantastic. Our only reservation is the fourth bedroom compromise for that front room.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, it just didn't feel big enough.
Yeah.
Would the size of the sitting room rule this property out?
No, we're going to have it's a discussion. It's not ruled out.
Yeah,
it's just that living room, we need to think about it, don't we?
Yeah.
I will try my best to get you something a little bit bigger, but there might be other compromises, you know, in terms of location or what's nearby to the property.
OK.
I reckon I've got off to a roaring start, and it's great to have a contender so early in the day. For our second property, I'm taking Vicky and Marvin to Las Macenas, an area on the outskirts of Mojacar Playa, a 10-minute drive south of the main strip. It takes its name from the defence tower built here in the 18th century to protect the beach against pirate attacks. On the way, I want to stop off at another historical landmark that I reckon Marvin, who spent some of his childhood in the Mediterranean, and the twins are going to love.
Now, I bet you're wondering what we're doing here. There's the next property.
Oh, perfect. How many bedrooms?
Just kidding. So I wanted to bring you to the Pirulico Watchtower, and it was used as an actual watchtower until the 16th century. So would you fancy climbing up that watchtower? You've got amazing views.
Yeah, I'm surprised you haven't already. It's itching to get up there.
Give me a couple of minutes.
Yeah.
This reminds me of my own childhood, you know, the ruggedness of Cyprus when I lived there. But going down the cliff, exploring the rock pools, I would love to introduce that to my little ones.
The property that we're looking at is only about a 20-minute walk from here.
Okay.
So this could be where you walk the dog each day.
Yeah, that's another box ticked for her.
So shall we go and have a look at this next property?
Yeah, let's have a look.
Let's do it. Coming up, I'm hoping to impress Vicky and Marvin by showing them a townhouse that comes with beautiful views. Today I'm in Mojacar on the beautiful Costa de Almeria in Spain, helping Vicky and Marvin find their perfect holiday home. And we got off to a very strong start. Our house hunters were really taken with the first property, a modern three-bedroom apartment near the beach with a kitchen to die for. Priced within their maximum budget of £300,000, they think it'll appeal to their 12-year-old twins and beloved Chihuahua Daisy. But they're keen to have more space for grandparents and guests to stay. So to offer them a bigger option, we've taken a 10-minute drive south to the less expensive and much quieter area of Las Macenas. Three-bedroom terraced houses here start from just over £155,000, way below their budget. I'm hoping that the extra space they can get here will win them over. This is it, then. We are looking at a house this time rather than an apartment. How do you feel about that?
Excited.
Absolutely,
yeah.
It's a little bit larger than the last property that we looked at. And so I'm hoping that's going to work with, you know, you needing to have a little bit more space. It is three bedrooms still.
OK.
We're on this community. There are two fabulous pools. Location-wise, we're a little bit further away from shops and bars and restaurants. How do you like the sound of that?
It's just so peaceful, isn't it?
It's chilled, isn't it?
Yeah, I really like it. Yeah. It's really pretty as well.
The other reason that we're here is because of the price. It's on the market for just over £258,500.
Much better. That would maybe allow us to think about having a car, which would solve not being near to the amenities,
Absolutely,
maybe.
Yeah, so that could be a win-win.
Shall we go and take a look inside?
Yes, ma'am.
It feels like I'm on a roll. So far, my second property seems to be going down nicely. This townhouse has access to the two communal pools and a communal garden. At the rear of the property is a ground floor covered patio area extending out to a small open backyard. Above the patio, there's a spacious covered terrace with gorgeous views of the Sierra de la Cabrera mountains and the sea. The front door leads directly into the upper floor, where there's an open plan living and dining room, leading round to a galley-style kitchen. The bedrooms are down on the floor below, where there's a main bedroom with an ensuite shower room and two further bedrooms with direct access onto the patio. There's also a separate family bathroom. So coming in, you can see the layout a bit better. You've got living area up here, because actually it's an upside down house. So the three bedrooms are down there.
Okay,
along with two bathrooms.
It's really modern, isn't it? It's a better shape, I think, from the last property. I think we can do more with it.
Yes, there's more room to maneuver. It's still a concern, if I'm absolutely honest.
Yeah. We'll have to see the rest.
I think something could be done.
Where did the dream of having a holiday home overseas come from?
My parents bought a place 15, 20 years ago in Cyprus, and just to have that kind of quality of life that they enjoyed. Yeah. And if we can share that with our two, then happy days.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Look at these views out here.
They're amazing, yeah. You've got sea view and a mountain view.
Even more than the wish list, isn't it?
Yeah,
we expected, you know, one or the other, but to be hit with two. Absolutely.
You've also got this garden area downstairs. It's not fenced, so it does mean that obviously you have to watch the dog, yeah?
Okay.
You have to keep her on a lead probably down there. But you've got gardeners that will look after the garden. Does that appeal to you?
Definitely, yeah.
Douche.
Yeah. Otherwise you'll be out there with your lawnmower for
not
God knows
so
how
much.
Long, you know? Yeah, no, that's a big plus.
So why don't you two go and see the rest and tell me what you think?
Okay.
Thank you. It's basic, but functional, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm not sure about this one.
No, it's too small. Yeah. There's no two ways about it.
Okay, wardrobe there. That's quite nice.
Yeah, I love the idea of walking out to the terrace.
Yeah, that's really nice, isn't it?
That's a plus, isn't it?
It's quite dark down here.
Yeah.
I think that would keep it cool, though, wouldn't it?
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Should we go and find Jasmine?
Yeah, let's.
This three-bedroom townhouse with mountain and sea views is on the market for just over £258,500. How will it stack up against our first property? Hello.
Hello.
So have you two seen it all now?
Yeah, we've had a good look around, haven't we?
Yeah. Like it?
The pros of the place, as far
as I'm
concerned.
Mountain view.
Yeah.
The overall, the outside areas were spot on, weren't they?
Yeah, all win-wins. Deal breaker for me personally is the kitchen. It's too small. You know, what we saw earlier, that's what we call a kitchen.
But you did say when we were there that the kitchen was not the most important room for you because you take everything out of the freezer and you're going to be eating out.
I think the whole house is kind of a little bit dark as well. But I don't know, I just didn't get a feel for it really.
So is this one in the running at all?
I would say no.
No, I wouldn't. You know, you set the bar high.
What would you like to see next then?
I think either somewhere with a bigger living space or preferably a fourth bedroom, I think.
Are you happy to travel to a different location other than Mojacar?
100%.
Yeah, definitely.
100%. So let's head back upstairs then and we'll go and see our next property.
Okay, perfect.
To widen the field, I'm taking Vicky and Marvin on a 40-minute drive away from Mojacar to the smaller town of San Juan de los Terreros. It's got a terrific family-friendly beach looking out towards a pair of small volcanic islands. The town is popular with Spaniards taking their family holidays and enjoying the laid-back vibe. So what are your first impressions?
We really like it here, don't we?
Yeah, absolutely. It's beautiful, the blue sea.
It just feels like such a nice, calm, family-orientated place. It's really pretty and authentic.
You don't get loads of foreign tourists coming here. But that's not to say there isn't loads of stuff going on. Water sports, beautiful promenade, lots of beach bars. Do you think your family would enjoy it here?
Yeah, I think they'd love it. It ticks all the boxes, doesn't it?
There's nothing to dislike. Yeah. Nothing to dislike. It's as simple as that.
Not worried about being a bit further from Mojacar?
No, I think I prefer it here.
Really?
I don't know if that's thrown a spanner in the works, but yeah, I really like it.
What she said.
So the property we're going to have a look at now is half an hour walk from here or 5 minutes in the car.
Okay.
Let's go and take a look. Coming up, I can't wait to wow Vicky and Marvin with this four-bedroom villa with its own private pool. Today, I'm house hunting in and around the stunning whitewashed town of Mojacar in Spain with Vicky and Marvin, who are looking for the perfect family holiday home. And so far, we've had mixed reactions. But we do have a contender, an apartment near the beach with a fantastic modern kitchen that wowed our house hunters. They now want to see if their £250,000 budget, with an additional £50,000 or so if needed, can get them a fourth bedroom. Vicky and Marvin are flexible about the location of their holiday home, so I've taken them to the small, family-friendly town of San Juan de los Terreros. Property here is around 25% cheaper than in Mojacar Playa, and well-presented four-bedroom villas start from around £275,000, with prices rising the closer you get to the coast. I've found one that's within half an hour's walk from the beach and which has something that I'm sure their twins Paige and Oliver will love. This is it, folks. Our next property.
Oh, wow.
It's an independent villa with a private pool.
Speechless, to be honest with you. I wasn't expecting that. It's a really nice sized pool as well, isn't it?
Looks good, low maintenance. Yeah. What's not to like?
Yeah.
What would the kids think of this?
They'd love it. I'd never get them out of it.
How do you feel about having your own sort of independent property rather than being part of a development?
It doesn't feel all that different, to be honest with you, here. It's still got a really nice sense of community, I think.
We have four bedrooms here.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I was not expecting that.
No.
Yeah, it's perfect.
The current asking price is just under £289,000.
Okay. Well, for four bedrooms and a pool.
I'm going to take that.
Yeah.
I'm really excited to show you around this one, so let's go and take a look inside.
I'm hoping this detached villa will give Vicky and Marvin the complete package for their holiday home. As well as a private pool and front patio space, the property has a backyard chill-out area with its own waterfall feature. There's a front balcony off the main bedroom with views of the mountains and sea. And a rooftop solarium at the rear of the property for soaking up that Spanish sun. It also has its own garage. On the ground floor, there's a large open-plan kitchen and living dining area leading out onto the front patio. And there are two bedrooms on this floor, plus a shower room. On the upper floor, there's an impressive main bedroom with doors to the front balcony that comes with its own ensuite bathroom and a handy walk-in dressing room. There's also a fourth good-sized bedroom with an ensuite.
This is it. So what do you think of inside?
Wow, open plan, really nice, really big space, kitchen, much more workable.
Yeah, it's really nice open plan. Wish, isn't it? Yeah.
So how would you personalise this? How would you have it yourselves?
We wouldn't have a lot of this furniture.
Actually, all the furniture is included in the price of house.
We would have all this furniture.
Yeah, but I was thinking a lot of it's quite heavy and dark and it's probably not really your style, is it?
No. Big TV on the wall. Giraffes gone. Happy days.
No. You don't need a big TV. We're in Spain.
So look at this main bedroom.
Wow. It's definitely the best so far. Yeah, it's really spacious, really nice. I've just seen that walk-in wardrobe. I don't know what I'd put in there, but I like it. Just seen the big bath in there. Yeah, it's really lovely.
Seems like you're very happy with this setup.
Yeah, this room's perfect. Yeah. Didn't change anything in this room at all.
No.
Why don't you two go and see the rest? And when you've seen all the house, find your way up to the rooftop solarium and I'll be waiting for you there.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. Enjoy. Well, look at those beaming smiles. I've got a really good feeling about this one.
Okay, fourth bedroom. It's a really nice size, actually, isn't
it? It's a fantastic size.
A bit of a balcony out there. Yeah, I like it.
It's a great size, yeah.
Okay, it's quite relaxing.
Yeah, I've no idea what we'd use this space for, but it's a nice feature.
Yeah, I really like it.
This four-bedroom villa with a pool is on the market for just under £289,000. Do we have a second contender on our hands?
Wow.
Look at these panoramic views.
It doesn't get any better than that.
This is an unexpected bonus, isn't it?
Yeah. We really love this location. Spot on.
So is there any concerns with this property?
I think 95% is all fantastic.
But we felt, especially the two back bedrooms, were really dark. That was the only real negatives.
Okay.
This is, you know...
Yeah, top.
This is
the one
spot.
To beat, yeah.
Since you love this location so much, how would you like to see another property nearby?
Yeah, we would love to.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, that's got me a bit excited.
Come on then, let's go.
I'm over the moon that Vicky and Marvin love San Juan de los Terreros so much, and it's given us our second contender. Space is really important to these house hunters, and this town offers more bang for their buck than pricier Mojacar Playa, where we started this search. Before we visit the next property, I'm taking our house hunters somewhere their 12-year-old twins, Paige and Oliver, will want to dive straight into.
I wanted to show you some of the other things that are available for you to do on your holidays in the area. And we've come to Aquaveda Water Park.
You know, without question, we'd have so much fun.
Yeah, I'd be down on the sun lounger and you'd be on daddy duty all day, wouldn't you?
So the kids quite adventurous when it comes to this sort of thing?
Yeah, they would love it.
Nearly as much as daddy.
Yeah.
So you can enjoy, you know, the different pools. You've got the lake pool, you've got 7 different slides. So there's something for everybody here.
Okay.
And the next property we're going to, as you know, is in San Juan de los Terreros.
Okay, yeah. Perfect.
It's located in a large, brand new development called Mar de Pulpi. The properties here have been built in the traditional whitewash style of many of the old villages in this part of Spain. The most expensive 3-bedroom frontline apartments here can go for around £380,000. But there are more affordable options too, priced within Vicky and Marvin's ideal £250,000 budget.
I wanted to take the opportunity to show you another property here. Now, we are looking at this one. It's top floor penthouse apartment.
Wow, okay.
And the apartment that we're looking at is brand new.
Yeah. Even better, yeah, it gets better.
The downside here, I'm afraid, is that we are back to 3 bedrooms.
Okay, I thought we might be.
So tell me what's going through your minds right now.
I just really want to like it. I really want it to be big enough because this is exactly what we had in our minds,
absolutely,
isn't it?
This one includes all the furniture, is non-negotiable.
Okay.
It's on the market for £250,000.
Okay, I'm nervous now.
Exactly, there's a sting in the tail somewhere. That's a concern now.
You go and see this one on your own, and then when you're finished in the apartment, I'll be waiting for you down by the pool.
Okay, lovely.
Thank you.
Enjoy. I think this property is going to be right up their street. But will they be willing to make the compromise of only having 3 bedrooms?
This penthouse apartment has a spacious front balcony, a huge rooftop solarium with fantastic sea and mountain views, and access to large landscape communal grounds and children's play area. There's also access to 3 separate communal pools, one for adults, one for kids, and one that's heated. The apartment also has its own secure car parking. Inside, there's an open-plan living and dining room and kitchen, a main bedroom and ensuite shower, 2 more double bedrooms, and another shower room.
Oh, wow. That kitchen looks really similar to ours at home, actually,
absolutely,
isn't it?
Absolutely, yeah.
Really big as well, isn't it?
Yeah. Then we haven't got a problem in the front room anymore, have we?
No.
Yeah,
we'd have to get a sofa bed, but that's no problem.
It's exactly what we'd be looking for, yeah. Furniture-wise.
Yeah, really nice. Nice ensuite in there.
Yep, a swoosh, isn't it?
Yeah. On the small side, but...
We can live with that.
Yeah.
There's no problem.
Oh, my goodness.
This is what I call a solarium.
Yeah. Compared to the solarium before,
yeah,
this just knocks it out of the water, doesn't
exactly.
it?
Exactly, there's so much we could do up here.
Oh, I love it.
This is fantastic.
It's got everything, hasn't it?
Yeah.
This three-bedroom penthouse apartment is on the market for £250,000, exactly the amount of Vicky and Marvin's original budget. Do we have another contender to add to the two we've already got? So, what do you think of all this?
I can't believe it. It doesn't seem like real life, does it?
Spectacular. We will struggle to find anything negative to say.
Not even the three bedrooms. You're not worried about that?
No,
because the living room just seemed big enough, and the two bedrooms, there's so much that we could do with them being single beds.
Well, we've forgotten about house one, two and three.
Yeah.
Oh, seriously?
Absolutely. It just, they don't compare.
I've still got a final property to show you, but I think this one is going to be extremely difficult to beat. If I were to say to you, we've got a villa, three bedrooms, but they can build you a pool to order.
That sounds like a nice problem for you to present.
Yeah.
OK, let's go and see our final property.
OK.
Coming up, I've set the bar pretty high now, but will my final property put the cat among the pigeons?
So what are you thinking?
I like it.
I really like it, but I'm a bit confused.
Today, I'm on Spain's gorgeous Costa de Almeria, searching for a holiday bolt hole for house hunters Vicky and Marvin. And I think I may just have found them the perfect property. Vicky and Marvin were absolutely blown away by the three-bedroom penthouse apartment. Its huge solarium was a massive plus point. And even though it didn't have a fourth bedroom, they still thought it would be large enough for visiting friends and family. The penthouse was right on my house hunter's £250,000 budget. But they do have an extra £50,000 or so available. So I want to push hard and see if I can show these house hunters a final option for their holiday home that gets their pulses racing even harder. But first, I'm taking a break from the search to see what a shade under £950,000 can get you in this part of the Costa de Almeria. We've been talking a lot about light and space, and this luxury property located less than half an hour's drive north of Mojacar has no shortage of either. I'm meeting the owner and developer who's agreed to show me around.
Hello, Tim.
Hello, Jasmine. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. Looking forward to seeing this lovely house. Is it new?
Absolutely brand new. A year ago, there was absolutely nothing here, just a bare piece of land.
I can't wait to have a look inside.
Come on, let's take you in. Yeah.
Wow, look at this place. This is amazing, isn't it? It's got such high ceilings, all that glass.
When we first saw the plot, and it's got this open view to the golf course, we thought we'd try and create a canvas, and it changes throughout the day. So you see it now in the daytime, but then at night time you get the hotel in the background with all its lights. It really is quite special.
I love the kitchen as well. It's very unusual.
We wanted to live in Spain. We wanted to do something different. So this has got sort of a Northern European feel to it as opposed to a traditional Spanish feel.
So where should we look at next?
Well, before we go outside, shall we take you a look upstairs?
I'd love to.
Come on then, we'll go upstairs. So, welcome to the main bedroom, Jasmine.
Nice, this is lovely. En suite.
En suite.
Although it's open, it's quite separate anyway, isn't it? It's sort of got its own little zone.
It works, we live here, it works for us. We didn't go the full hog. They were trying to convince us to put glass windows through the toilet, but we didn't go down that route.
Oh, so you have got a door on the toilet.
We have got a door on the toilet, yes. Yeah.
Wow, look at this beautiful pool. You've got so much space out here, haven't you, with the outside kitchen and living and dining area.
So this is another room outside, so you try and create that extra living space.
And I love the way it's all planted.
Well, I suppose we cheated a little bit there because that was our sort of industry that we were in, was importing architectural plants from here in Spain back to the UK. The big palm trees, big olive trees, and they have that instant impact.
Thank you so much for showing me around. I'm going to get back to my house hunters now.
You're more than welcome. It's been a pleasure. Thank you very much. Are we ready? Come on.
I could have happily stayed out on that lovely terrace watching the sun go down. But right now, I need to get back to the job in hand. Because Vicky and Marvin were so smitten with the last property they viewed, I want to offer them something else within the same development. I think there are definitely good options here for our house hunters. There are currently 1,500 completed properties on the site, with another 1,400 in the pipeline, and around half of them are bought as holiday homes. There aren't any four-bedroom properties available here at the moment, but as the three-bedroom apartment I showed Vicky and Marvin earlier definitely put smiles on their faces, I now want to see if a larger three-bedroom villa will be the real cherry on the cake.
Right. This is it, the final property.
It's big. Yeah. It's impressively big.
Yeah, I wasn't expecting this.
Yeah, I like.
Yeah.
It's three bedrooms, also three bathrooms. Inside is unfurnished, and you can choose your own fittings. It's on the market for just under £301,000.
I was expecting a lot more than that.
Right, exactly.
Obviously, this is a little bit more expensive than the apartment, and it doesn't come with furniture, but they will put the pool in for you, included in the price.
We're going to get the biggest pool available then, yeah. Included in the price. Again, I'd like to just, you know, I'm chomping at the bit to go inside.
Yeah? Come on, let's go and take a look.
Because it will have its own private swimming pool, this property won't have access to the three communal pools that the penthouse apartment does. There's a huge terrace with views across to one of the volcanic islands and the mountains. The ground floor has a large living room leading out into the private garden and opening directly into the kitchen. There's also a ground floor bedroom with an ensuite shower and a handy utility room. Up on the first floor, there are the second and third bedrooms, each with its own ensuite shower room and access to the terrace.
So how do you like this space?
Wow, it's really big, isn't it?
Yeah, I wasn't expecting this, and the kitchen is just fantastic as well. Jasmine, you've given us a problem, but a nice problem.
Yeah.
It is a problem.
Things like the light fittings can all be done for you as part of a furniture package in the region of about £17,000. Do you think that's something you'd do?
I just think that would be easier.
Oh, without question.
I don't know if it would all add up to
that
anyway. So, yeah, we'd definitely be looking into that.
So far, so good.
So far, so good, yeah.
Upstairs, we've got this bedroom. It's got an ensuite. Plenty of fitted wardrobes. You've got access to the massive terrace outside.
Swish, stylish.
Yeah.
Exactly really our style as well, yeah, absolutely.
When you compare this one to the apartment that we've just seen, is one edging ahead, do you think?
For me, they're neck and neck at the minute. I don't know whether it's because it was all done out and, you know, priced, and just that amazing pool. I'm really confused at the minute.
No, I can picture where we can have our own stamp on something like this.
Yeah.
That's where I'm coming from.
Right, so is this a bit of a difference of opinion, maybe?
I'm still in love with the earlier place as well.
Why don't you have a look at the rest on your own and then we'll chat afterwards and see where we're at.
Okay.
Well, I have no idea how this is going to turn out. They seem to love both properties and they seem also somewhat confused.
Right, okay. So, good size?
Yeah, so that is the master then.
Yeah, that is the master room.
It's nice that there's the ensuite for this one as well.
Absolutely, and the storage room.
Yeah, I really like it. This is swaying me a little bit now.
Okay.
This large villa is on the market right at the very top end of Vicky and Marvin's budget for just under £301,000. Well, looking around, the rest of the property have helped them decide if it's a new favourite.
This is some size, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a lot like the solarium in the last place.
Oh, this is spectacular, isn't it?
I thought I might find you two out here. This is amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really nice.
So much space.
Yeah, really big.
So what are you thinking?
I like it.
I really like it, but I'm still, my head, probably heart is still with the other place at the minute. But I'm not 100% on that. I'm a bit confused.
You seem to like the idea of having your own private pool and your own private villa.
Yeah, for me, you know, it's the bigger rooms, the bigger downstairs, bigger kitchen.
Yeah, no,
I can personalise it.
Yeah.
Is that really important for a holiday home? Perhaps not, but, you know, if we retire here, that's, you know, where it comes into the equation.
It's been such a great house hunt and I'm so pleased that we've ended today with two really strong contenders.
Yeah.
What's it going to come down to then, this decision?
I have no idea. Just a really long discussion this evening.
Yeah, you normally get your own way.
Yeah, but I don't even know what my own way would be.
You know what, I think if you've seen everything you need to see here, we should head back.
Yeah.
And then in the morning, let me know if you've managed to make a decision.
Okay.
Yeah? If you'd like more information on any of the properties featured on today's show, visit aplaceinthesun.com/programmes.
We've now shown Vicky and Marvin five properties in and around Mojacar, all within their maximum budget of £300,000, with a little bit of leeway for a perfect contender. They liked most of the homes I picked out for them, but it was the last two that really hit the spot. A penthouse apartment with access to communal pools and a large villa on the same site with space to build its own pool. I can't wait to find out which one they think will make the perfect holiday home for their twins and Chihuahua Daisy.
So, how was your evening, guys?
It's been quite fraught the last few hours.
Yeah.
So, how has your conversation gone then?
Well, it's been down to the last two properties.
Yeah.
Backwards and forwards. We each favoured one quite strongly, didn't we?
I think we love the apartment. There's no two ways about it. But when we were introduced to the villa, I just saw a better long-term option.
How about you, Vicky?
I was more for the here and now. What Marvin was saying was not making sense to me, but then I think he felt the same, so it was back and forth, back and forth.
Oh, my goodness.
And then I think we were this morning sat at opposite ends of the pool, weren't we, for a little while? So to have a break from each other.
Have you actually managed to find some sort of mutually agreeable middle ground?
After a conversation that's been going to and fro in, we would like to make an offer on one of the properties. And it is the apartment.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
How did you arrive at that decision?
That's a very good question.
Well, we thought about what was best for the kids, because that's the stage that we're at now in our lives.
Are you happy with that decision?
I know Paige and Oliver are going to be really happy. The wife is happy, so it's all good in the hood.
So it's on for 250. The developer has said that they're non-negotiable. So what do you want to go in at?
I appreciate the non-negotiable, but I would like to put an offer. We would like to put an offer of £240,000.
I'm happy to put that in for you and see what they say.
Okay.
Yeah?
Okay, yeah.
So, hi, Danny. Vicky and Marvin would like to make an offer on the apartment that we looked at yesterday of £240,000. They are cash buyers. That would be great. Thank you so much. OK, bye-bye.
Didn't say
no. So he said he's going to speak to the developer and come back to us as soon as possible.
OK.
How are you feeling?
Sick.
If they come back with a counter offer, or if they come back and say, sorry, no, we said it's non-negotiable, what happens then?
I think we'll cross that bridge when we come
to it.
Okay. Oh. Hi, Danny. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll call you back. Thank you. So, unfortunately, that offer hasn't been accepted, but they've come back with a counter offer of just under £245,000.
You're the boss for 5 minutes.
What do you think?
Let's accept that then.
Yes?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Let me call them back.
Now, hang on a second. Should we just try it? Even just another grand off.
Just try it.
Yeah.
Yeah? So you'd like to go back at £244,000?
Yeah, let's go for £244,000.
What are you like? Okay. You won't be expecting this call.
Be gentle.
So, Danny, would they be willing to accept £244,000? Speak to you soon. Bye-bye. It's so exciting. I mean, have you spoken to the children about it?
No, we haven't
had
a chance to.
Spoke to
your dad,
father.
Didn't we?
Yeah. What did he say?
As per usual, he took Victoria's side. So.
Favourite daughter-in-law.
Oh. Hi, Danny. Can you bear with me just a sec? I'm just going to put you on hold. They've accepted £244,000.
Oh, my goodness. Congratulations, thank you.
I wasn't expecting you to say that.
Danny, thank you so much. That's a deal. Thank you. Congratulations!
There is a God.
I'm so happy for you guys. Cheers.
Cheers. Thank
you. Good
you.
Luck with it.
Thank you very much.
What a roller coaster of a house hunt this has been for Vicky and Marvin. But I'm so thrilled that they finally managed to agree on their perfect property in their perfect location.